let's write down unequal contributing resonating structure. Write down, in this case, we cannot find out the exact value of bond order, but we can find out the range of the bond order. Exact value they won't ask you also in the exam for unequal contributing. Okay, so in this one example, you see range of bond order. We can say bond order lies in this range. Okay, like the first example, I have already taken this example, CH2 negative C double bond O OH or O negative. Okay, now the resonating structure of this is what? CH2 double bond O minus and H. These are equal contributor, yes or no? How do we find out equal contributor or not?
So there should be a part which is not.
No. How do we find out equal contributing structure if their stability is same? Correct? Are they, have same stability?
No.
Because for this we use the rules of relative stability of resonating structure. Obviously this one is what? This one is less stable because negative charge or oxygen. So now when you have the rules, you will have the idea that what rules you have to apply. Itna sochna nahi hai ki rule 1, rule 2, rule. That directly you can apply. Tell you, see, equal pi bond, oxygen on negative charge, carbon negative. This is more stable. Now when this is more stable, so this contributes more into the structure. Correct? Now if you have to find out the bond order of carbon-carbon bond for this polymer. Okay? Exact value we cannot find out, but we can say the bond order of carbon-carbon bond lies in this range. First of all, this 1 to 2, because here we have 1, here we have 2, right? Now since this one is more stable, so this contributes more, right? So we can further write that the bond order lies in this range, 1.5 and 2, right? Understood this? So we can write down the range, we cannot write down the exact value in case of unequal contributing. Okay, now what is the bond order of carbon oxygen bond? What is the range for this?
1 and 1.5.
It is 1 to 1.5. Clear? So for this you should know the rules which RS is more stable. Accordingly you can write down the range of bond order. Got it? I'll write down some examples. Okay, one example write down.
Sir, if the contribution is like 60%, 40%, then the bond order can be...
No, that is difficult to judge. 60, 40 or 70, 30. That's why we'll write down range. We don't write exact. Okay? Next one you see. Chlorobenzene. Have you heard about chlorobenzene?
Yes.
What is chlorobenzene? Suppose this is bond A and bond B, carbon chlorine bond, right? Carbon chlorine bond. Tell me the bond order of A and B, bond order comparison of A and B.
What bond is that?
It's
CCS bond.
What's the name of this compound?
Huh? This one is chlorobenzene.
That's
this one is what? Cyclic ring or hex, cyclohexane, chlorocyclohexane.
The first one doesn't have the double bond.
It is cyclohexane and chlorine attachment. B is more stable. Why? Here we have resonance. Do we have resonance here? No. Here we have resonance because pi sigma lone pair conjugated system. So we can draw the resonating structure, right? So when you draw the resonating structure, we'll have partial double bond characteristics here. That's why it's negative double bond and double bond Cl positive. Right? So partial double bond characteristics we have between carbon and chlorine. That's why the second bond order is more. Bond order of B is more.
So more stable.
No, we are talking about this bond. Aromatic is this ring. We are talking about carbon-chlorine bond.
Carbon-chlorine bond is Can't we say the whole thing has more density structures in it, so that's more stable?
No, the stability is stability of what?
Of the whole thing, right?
No, but both of them aren't resonance of each other.
See, point is, this is the different molecule. This is a different molecule. Overall stability, if you ask me, this is aromatic compound. Because ring is more stable. Obviously, this one is more stable. But here we are trying to find out the bond order of carbon-chlorine bond. Like I said, bond order between two atoms, we'll say, in a molecule. So we're talking about bond order of this bond and this bond. Since here we do not have resonance, so bond order of this bond we can write. Bond order is one, exactly one. But here it will be between one and two. Right? So obviously the bond order of B is more than to that of. That's why aryl halide, chlorine on benzene, right? That we call it as aryl halide. When you remove one hydrogen from chlorine, it becomes aryl. Aryl halide is stronger than the normal alkyl halide because of resonance. Because of this resonance, it develops a partial double bond characteristics and it's difficult to break. Okay? So in comparison, alkyl halide and aryl halide is more stable. Carbon halogen bond is more stable than carbon halogen bond in alkyl.
Yeah.
First one carbon carbon chlorine bond is more strong.
If the second one's less stable, so won't it want to change back into the first structure?
That is a different thing. But it has some partial level bond characteristics. Because of resonance. Because this delocalized will be there. Because it's continuously there. If you draw the actual structure, the actual structure is this. Partial double bond. That's why the second one bond. And we know the order of bond length and bond strength. Bond order and bond strength is directly proportional, and bond length is inversely proportional. So any one of these questions, if they ask in the exam, you can compare with this. Okay? This question, you tell me. Bond order of alpha beta bond. This is alpha, this is beta, and this is. Bond alpha means this carbon carbon bond.
Okay.
Beta is this, gamma is this.
So the bond stability.
Bond order.
Bond order beta, beta is alpha. The highest beta, than beta, alpha beta. And gamma.
Oh, it's beta, alpha, beta, gamma, not nomenclature,
beta,
right?
Beta,
just, they are not nomenclature, right?
No. It's just the representation. This carbon-carbon bond is alpha, carbon-carbon bond is beta, carbon-carbon bond is gamma. Like here we have carbon-chlorine bond is A, carbon-chlorine bond is B. Which one is the most?
Beta.
What is the bond order of this? It's 2. And what about this alpha?
1 to 2.
Right? And this one is? 1. Right? So beta is max, then alpha, and then gamma. Okay? What about this one? CH2 double bond CH, OH. And CH3, CH2, OH. Carbon oxygen alpha, carbon oxygen beta, alpha beta comparison.
Alpha is greater.
Between what you have to compare?
Alpha greater.
Because that has only single bond. You have to know this. When oxygen bonded with 2 bond, it has 2 lone pairs. So it is conjugated, right? System is conjugated. So this develops partial double bond characteristics. And that's why the bond order of alpha is more than to that of beta. Okay? Bond order of alpha and beta.
Beta greater than gamma.
There's no gamma.
Alpha.
Why?
So this has more resonating structures.
So
if we do that division by number of resonating structures, this one will have less. If you use the other formula.
Alpha is less.
Yes,
alpha. Okay. See, we have this lone pair and this lone pair. And because of this resonance, it develops a partial double bond characteristics. Right? So here the bond order of beta is what? Less than 2 but greater than 1. Okay? Yeah, alpha bond order is what? It is 1 here. In this molecule, there is no resonance. No resonance when I say it means this lone pair is not involved in resonance. Why? Because there is conjugation, but because of this group CH3, there is a steric repulsion here. And because of this steric repulsion, this group changes its plane. So the entire molecule is not planar now. Okay? So this CH3, one of the CH3 will go into the plane. You know this bond? It is coming out of the plane, the dark wedge. And this wedge is into the plane.
So what is
the CS3. See, because of this two group present, we'll have a steric repulsion here. Right? Steric repulsion means hindrance. Both this CS3, this is pushing each other. So because of this hindrance, stability decreases. Right, and to minimize this hindrance, what happens? This, the plane of this molecule will change. It rotates to minimize the repulsion and adjust the steric repulsion. Is the repulsion here? This group and CH3 repulsion.
So, but why doesn't that CH3 and that carbon, that CH2, not that much repulsion?
If you have this group present, OC double bonds is bulky group, right?
CH.
And if any group is present here, suppose cyclopropyl like this. Then since these two groups are big, so we'll have a steric repulsion. Right, both groups will push each other, right? And because of this steric repulsion, the stability decreases, you see. So here also we'll have this steric repulsion, right? So this question, if you get in the exam, directly you'll do it wrong. Kya nahi ho to pata nahi ho. Aisa hai, theek hai? Organic chemistry is like that only. You'll see many things where the basic logic won't apply. You cannot say, you can ask, sir, where we consider this steric repulsion? Right, you can ask this question. So I can say when there is bulky group attached, right? So because of this steric repulsion, stability changes and you should know when you have to apply. Ortho position, if any group present and this thing is present, this will have the steric repulsion. And to minimize this repulsion, it changes its plane and you don't have to do anything into it. It adjusts in such a way so that the repulsion is minimized.
So it won't have any conjugation.
Rotation will happen, the plane of this and this will change. So this one is like this, another one is like this. So it's not parallel orbital. No resonance. No conjugation, no resonance.
Sir, is steric repulsion the same as steric hindrance?
Yes, correct. Steric crowding, steric repulsion, steric hindrance, all are same thing. Okay, steric crowding, steric repulsion, steric hindrance, all are same thing. So because of this steric hindrance, this NH3 hole twice changes its planes and this becomes non-planar now, the entire molecule. And hence the resonance is not possible. Write down this example properly. Okay? So alpha is 1, beta is this. So the bond order of beta is more than that of.
So there was only one bond there, and the right one was where it's surface repulsion.
Which one? All the bonds. This entire thing will be under repulsion.
So if one of those bonds is on this, like this bond is there, only this bond is there.
Then it is not repulsion. That's what the difference between the two bonds. Done.